Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Google Plus Developers Live. I'm Silvano Luciani, and I'm a developer programs engineer for Google Plus.
And I'm Joanna Smith, and I am also a developer programs engineer for Google Plus. And today, we are here to talk to you about Google Plus Platform Insights.
Yes, the goal is to get you fully set up to learn as much as you can about your app from this extra analytics for Google Plus sign-in.
Exactly. But first, we want to take a moment to really talk about what are Google Plus Platform Insights.
Yes, good point. As mentioned, Google Plus Platform Insights are a set of Google analytics that are specific to Google Plus sign-in functionalities, such as the Google Plus sign-in and interactive posts. Mm-hmm.
So for the sign-in button specifically, we have two different things. You can compare your total number of users against the number of new users for a given time period. And then for an interactive post, you have the ability to track the viral spread of a post through multiple different metrics.
Yes, we provide data on the number of interactive posts published, post views, clicks, click-through rate, and on-app install clicks.
Exactly. And then because it's Google Analytics, you can look at all of this data over a period of 30 days or over a period of 7 days. And you can also break it down by platform between web, Android, and iOS, which gives you the full ability to track what your users are doing and where they're doing it.
And to get access to all of this data, the first thing that you need to do is link your Plus page with your project in the Google Plus in the Google API console. To do this, we have instructions at developers.google.com/plus/features/analytics.
Exactly. And these are the instructions that I'm going to follow and show you today, so you can follow along if you're interested. But to get there, let's take a look at our documentation. And so if you're exploring the documentation in general, you can find these instructions through the left nav under Features, Insights. But what we have here is we have a lot of information about what Google Plus Platform Insights are. And you can learn about the different metrics that are available and also kind of some ideas of what they might mean for you as a developer. And at the bottom of the page, we have setup instructions. And they're very specific, they're very clear, and you shouldn't have any trouble. But if you do, be sure to let us know. So the first page, or the first step, is just to get the Plus page ID. And you can do that from the Plus page dashboard. So to find this dashboard, you can actually click on the link there, or you can find it from the left nav within Google Plus and click on Pages. And you'll see every Plus page that you are a manager of. So this is my test page for today. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Connected Services. And this takes me to a page, and I can see that the Google API's console is one of the options already. And if I click Start, this is how I'm going to find my Plus page ID. So you can go ahead and copy this to your clipboard. And then if you're interested, you can click through the rest of the wizard to see what the next steps are going to be. But I already know the rest of the steps, and I'm going to show you, so let's skip ahead to that. So within the Google APIs console, which we've taken you to multiple times, there are multiple tabs. But for today, all you need to worry about is the Overview tab, because all we care about is this Google Plus page field, where you can request a connection, and all you have to do is paste in the Plus page ID. But we are Google and we care about security, so it's not so simple as just having an ID. You'll see that this is pending. And what that means is that you have to go back to your dashboard, go ahead and refresh the Connected Services tab. Let's find it. So go back to Connected Services, and you'll see that now we have this API console, and it'll have the name and the project number, which aren't terribly descriptive, but yours will be much more indicative. And it's requesting an approval. And here I can approve it. So we have a two-way mutual approval street to really protect your app. And so what happens now is if we return to the dashboard one more time, we will see that the Platform Insights button has replaced the Connected Services tab, which has moved into the More field. So it's easy for you to get to your insights very quickly. And now we have no data for me because it's a new page, but you can break it down by feature to see what's going on between total users or new users, or switch to interactive posts, and maybe I only care about the non-existent web data.
Yeah, so at this point, as you can see, you can start learning a lot about how your app is behaving. Unfortunately, Joanna's demo page doesn't have any data, but we are sure that your app will be far more interesting, and we are sure that Google Plus Insight will be a valuable resource for you.
Exactly. And so the other thing we wanted to mention today is related to an announcement that we made this morning. And if you're watching this GDL, you're probably already convinced of our many different value propositions for Google Plus sign-in. But this morning's announcement just is one more reason to really strive for a deep integration with Google Plus. And what we talked about was we announced Google or App Activity's integration with Search. So you can really start to see some of the Google Plus data that you as a developer get to write surfacing within Search. And what this means is that using Google Plus sign-in is more than Google Plus. It's a gateway to Google. And when you write data like App Activities, you are writing that data not just to a user's profile, but to Google so that we can surface it in interesting and creative ways across all of our products. So this is just the beginning, and we're really excited to see what this will mean for you as a developer.
Yeah, and to find more about it, go check the announcement on the Google Plus Developers blog at googleplusplatform.blogspot.com.
Exactly.
Now, let's see. No, we don't have any questions for this episode. So if you want to learn more about the Google Plus platform, you can find more details and in our documentation site at developers.google.com/plus. And also remember, if you have any questions, please reach out to us in the Google Plus developer community on Google Plus.
Exactly. Or you can use the Stack Overflow tag, Google-Plus, because we check that every day, and we really like to be able to answer your questions and help you. And then, of course, if you just want to learn about the product and maybe get started with tinkering with it on your own, you can see all of our language examples at github.com/Google+.
And last but not least, if you find a bug in our APIs or you have any suggestion or feature request, use our issue tracker, please, file requests, file bugs, and also star the bugs and the feature requests you agree with, because we use the star when we triage the bugs and feature requests every week.
So I do. I triage those every week. So please star things that are important to you, because that'll let me know that developers think that that issue is important. So that's everything that we have for you today. We hope that Platform Insights really help you out. And thanks for joining us.
Bye-bye.